कौन से सर का? ध्रुव सर का। चालू कर दी ना रिकॉर्ड। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कोएगुलेशन। यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड सम मेथड्स ऑफ सेपरेशन ऑफ कोलॉइड्स लाइक इलेक्ट्रोफोरेसिस। सो टुडे कोएगुलेशन, व्हाट इज कोएगुलेशन? सो कोएगुलेशन इज रिलेटेड टू द charged particle present in the colloids, okay? When a lyophobic solution the colloid particles present in lyophobic solve contain positive and negative charges, okay? So these charged particles of colloid comes towards each other and make an aggregate, or we can call it precipitate. This is also known as the coagulate. Okay, so the charged particles present in colloid salt, which type of colloid salt? Lyophobic salt. Okay, so in lyophobic salt, the charged particle of colloid particles comes together and they join together, they attach together and form an aggregate, and this aggregate is called the precipitate or coagulate, and this phenomenon is called the coagulation or precipitation. Clear? So after the precipitation or making aggregate, they will settle down in the bottom of the beaker. This is coagulate, or we can call it precipitate. So you will write the definition. When the lyophobic salt is due to presence of charged colloid particles, they make aggregate or coagulate. Okay, and this phenomenon is called the coagulation or precipitation. Switch off your mics. Switch off your mics. Move out. Okay, now we are discussing methods of using coagulation. Coagulation. So there are following methods. There are five types of methods in your syllabus, but according to syllabus, we will here discussing three methods. Okay, so first one is by adding electrolyte. So in this method, when we add excess of electrolyte, and we know that electrolyte contains charged particles. Okay, electrolyte particles. So the particles negative particles and positive particles present in this electrolyte, they neutralize this whole solution and they neutralize this whole solution and make a coagulate or a precipitate. Okay. So this is the first method by which can use coagulate. Now, the second method is by boiling. Second method is by boiling. So, in this manner, when we heat a colloidal solution, for example, if you have a solution of colloid, this is colloidal solution. When you heat it, the colloidal particle will move faster, okay? Will move faster due to the increase in kinetic energy, due to the increasing in kinetic energy, and due to this kinetic energy, they get collided together. Okay, they get collided together. So when these particles, see, we know that there are the absorbed layer on the colloidal particles. There is a adsorbed layer. Okay, there is a adsorbed layer is present on the colloidal particles, but when we heat it, the collision due to the movement, they collide together, and when they collide together, this adsorbed layer become disturbed. This adsorbed layer will disturb, and due to this disturbance, the layer will disturb, and this disturbance, the charge on these particle will increase. Okay, and hence their charge increases. Okay, increases. So what will happen then? Because of the charge increasing, they attract each other, and when they attract by each other, they will form an aggregate. So there will be a positive and a negative, and when they comes together, they will form an aggregate, and this aggregate is called coagulate. So in this method we are using heat. Okay, अगर हिंदी में बात करते हैं तो हिंदी में हम क्या कहेंगे कि आपके कोलोइडी सॉल हैं, कोलोइडी कणों को, यानी आप जब उन्हें गर्म करते हैं, आपने उनका क्वथन करते हैं, उसका हीट करते हैं, गर्म करते हैं, तो उनके जो कण हैं वो क्या हो जाते हैं, मूव करते हैं, मतलब घूमते हैं, और उनकी वजह से उनके बीच में टक्करों की संख्या बढ़ जाती है. टक्करों की संख्या बढ़ने के कारण और इनके जो ऊपर एक अधिशोषित जो लेयर है, ठीक है, परत है, वो क्या हो जाती है, फट जाती है, और उस परत के वजह से इनके ऊपर जो चार्ज मतलब आवेशित जो कि ये कोलोइड कण होते हैं, तो ये क्या होने लगते हैं, ये जुड़ के स्कंदन बनाने लगते हैं, ठीक है, और फाइनली ये क्या हो जाते हैं, स्कंदन बना लेते हैं. तो आपने इंग्लिश में भी समझ लिया एंड हिंदी में. नाउ द नेक्स्ट मेथड इज by electrophoresis. So in last class we already discussed about the electrophoresis. I told you that the electrophoresis that there is a U-shaped a glass tube of U-shape, and in this glass tube will keep a colloidal solution and fit some electrodes here. With two electrodes, one is the cathode and one is the other one is anode. Okay, so now when we switch on the battery of these electrodes, the current will flow, and due to the current the charged particles present in this colloidal solution goes towards the negative electrodes means opposite charge electrodes. That means if this is cathode containing positive charge, then negative particles will come together towards it, and if this is an anode, that means that it is a negative electrode, the positive charge particle comes together towards the anode. Hence these particle will deposit on these electrodes and you can extract them after the electrophoresis. ओके, तो हिंदी में बात करते हैं तो क्या बोलते हैं इसको? विद्युत कर्ण संचलन. विद्युत कर्ण संचलन में क्या करना है आपको? यू आकार की ट्यूब लेनी है और इसमें आपको कोलोइडी विलयन आपको भर देना है, और इसमें दो इलेक्ट्रोड जब आप लगा देते हैं और इलेक्ट्रोडों को जब आप बैटरी से जोड़ देते हैं और करंट इसमें यानी विद्युत धारा प्रवाहित करते हैं, तो इसमें उपस्थित जो कोलोइडी कण होते हैं जिनके ऊपर आवेश होते हैं धनात्मक और ऋणात्मक, ये अलग अलग इलेक्ट्रोडों के ऊपर जाने लगते हैं. यानी कि आपका पॉजिटिव अगर ये है कैथोड, तो कैथोड की तरफ आपका नेगेटिव पार्टिकल यानी कि ऋणावेशित कोलोइडी कण जाने लगते हैं, और आपके जो एनोड है यानी कि आपका नेगेटिव यानी कि ऋणावेशित इलेक्ट्रोड है जो, उसकी तरफ आपका क्या पॉजिटिव पार्टिकल यानी कि धनावेशित कोलोइडी कण जाने लगते हैं, और फिर ये जो कण हैं ये इस पर क्या हो जाते हैं? डिपॉजिट हो जाते हैं. इसका मतलब उसके ऊपर जमा हो जाते हैं. ठीक है, और जब फिर आपका ये इलेक्ट्रो जो फोरेसिस या वैद्युत कण संचलन प्रोसेस ये पूरा हो जाता है, कंप्लीट हो जाता है, यानी कि कोलोइडी कण पूरे तरीके से सेपरेट हो जाते हैं, तो आप इसको अलग अलग कर सकते हैं. तो हिंदी में और इंग्लिश में दोनों में आपको समझ में आ गया है? जो हिंदी मीडियम वाले बच्चे हैं उन्हें भी आ गया है समझ में? चलिए अब इसके बाद बात करते हैं नेक्स्ट टॉपिक की. तो नेक्स्ट है आपका हार्डी शूल जे. Hardy Schulze rule. So in this rule, this rule was given by the Hardy and Schulze. Okay, this rule was proposed by the Hardy and Schulze. So according to this rule, when increasing in the valency of the, when greater the valency of the flocculation Floculation is also known as the coagulation. Floculation ion added. Floculation ions added. The greater is the power of the greater. Is the power to form a precipitate. To form a precipitate. That means the greater the valency of the floculation ion. The ion which have more valency, that means they have more charge on it, then its valency be greater and they will form the coagulate faster. For example, like, so you can write here in short, degree of coagulation is directly proportional to valency of effective ion used. Valency of effective ion. Okay. So there are some examples like Al3 plus, Ba2 plus, Na2 plus. So which one of them will form a coagulate faster? So according to this relation, you can see here, greater the valency, effective valency, okay, greater the charge, okay. So valency means the charge. Here valency is means that more the charge and more the coagulation. So the element or ion which have the more charge, they will form coagulation faster. Okay, so here Al plus 3 will form the coagulation faster in comparison of Ba2 positive, and Ba2 positive form coagulation in comparison of Na positive, here only one positive. So here you can see this is the direct relation, more the charge, greater the charge, greater the coagulation. Okay, this was given by the Hardy-Schulze. So this is the power of coagulation. Of cations. Now we are talking about the power of or coagulating power of negative ions. So there are some examples like FeCN whole six, PO4 3 negative. SO4 2 negative and Cl negative. So here you can see this is the 4 negative. That means greater the negative ion. Hence, greater the charge, greater the coagulation. So this is the coagulating power of anions. So this is the order of the coagulating power of anions. So this is you can easily say that charges are directly proportional to the so this was end. Now we will start the next class.